The Supreme Court verdict on Rafale, huge for the government and the IAF. But is this really an embarrassment for the Congress? It really depends on who you ask.
Finally, a sigh of relief for the Modi government. The Rafale fighter jet deal will not be probed by the CBI. The top court on Thursday dismissed petitions for reviewing the court's December 2018 verdict, which had declined CBI probe. Former BJP ministers Yashwant Sinha, Arun Shori, activist advocate Prashant Bhushan and others petitioned the court with a Hindu newspaper report on internal notings, which claimed to show a serious difference of opinion within the defence ministry over the deal. In a unanimous verdict, Chief Justice of India and Justice S.K. Kaul said, "There's no need to direct the CBI to file an FIR into the Rafale deal. It is not the duty of the court to determine the price of the Rafale deal on the basis of mere suspicion of petitioners. Apples cannot be compared with oranges. In other words, the terms of this contract cannot be compared with the old deal that the UPA was trying to negotiate for 126 Rafale fighters. Petitioners want to construe themselves as an appellate authority and want the court to decide the same." Justice K.M. Joseph, in a separate judgment, agreed with the Chief Justice and Justice S.K. Kaul, but said, "Petitioners can approach the CBI for registering an FIR provided the CBI gets the nod from the government as per the Prevention of Corruption Law."
जो हमारी complaint थी CBI के सामने, उसमें बहुत serious charges, cognizable offences के प्रधानमंत्री और लोगों के खिलाफ लगाए गए थे। उस पर कायदे से FIR register होनी चाहिए थी। अब CBI को पहले सरकार की अनुमति लेनी पड़ेगी FIR register करने से पहले।
The top court dealing with contempt case against Rahul Gandhi for his remarks, quoting the top court verdict and accusing Prime Minister Modi as chokidar chor hai, let him off with a warning. The Supreme Court told Rahul Gandhi to be careful in future. The court said that persons holding important positions in political spectrum must be more careful. No court should be dragged into political discourse.
Rahul Gandhi ke khilaf contempt hua tha. सुप्रीम कोर्ट को मिसकोट करने के लिए कांग्रेस ने झूठ बोला हमारे ईमानदार लोकप्रिय प्रधानमंत्री के खिलाफ कैंपेन किया और झूठ पर झूठ बोलते गए आज राहुल गांधी आपको माफी मांगना जरूरी है
मैं सुप्रीम कोर्ट के इस फैसले का स्वागत करता हूं मैं समझता हूं कि डिफेंस प्रिपेयरनेस से जुड़े हुए मामलों का किसी भी सूरत में राजनीतिकरण नहीं किया जाना चाहिए और इससे हमारी सरकार के स्टैंड का विंडिकेशन हुआ है इस फैसले के परिणाम स्वरूप बल्कि हमारी सरकार की जो डिसीजन मेकिंग की जो ट्रांसपेरेंसी है उस पर भी सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने अपनी मुहर लगा दी है
रफेल केस में पुनर्विचार याचिका पर सुप्रीम कोर्ट का निर्णय आज ये साबित करता है कि रफेल के भ्रष्टाचार की आपराधिक जांच का रास्ता सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने आज खोल दिया है
फॉर एयरफोर्स दिस मीन्स विंडिकेशन इन टू वेज फर्स्टली Negotiations were held by successive deputy chiefs of the Indian Air Force. Secondly, after today's verdict, complex defense acquisitions will be more smooth. In New Delhi with Sunil Prabhu, this is Arunachalam Vaidyanathan, NDTV.
Well, joining us, Prashant Bhushan, senior advocate in the Supreme Court, somebody who argued this case. Air Marshal SVP Sinha, the former Deputy Chief of Air Staff, joins us in a few moments from now. He was one of the Deputy Chiefs of the IAF who actually, and most recently, in fact, negotiated the deal before it was actually signed. Vivek Reddy, lawyer and BJP leader, Mamta Kale, with us as well. We should be joined by Dr. Abhishek Singhvi of the Congress in a little while from now. Mr. Bhushan, let me come to you first. The Supreme Court said it appears that the endeavor of the petitioners is to construe themselves as an appellate authority to determine each aspect of the contract and call upon the court to do the same. In other words, implying that you were perhaps judge, jury and executioner, not taking into account the views of others. Is this perhaps the strongest criticism of what has been your argument, sir?
No, I don't think that this is a valid criticism at all, because we were not trying to say that, we were not even asking the court to determine whether this deal was tainted with corruption, etc. We were just telling the court that we have lodged this complaint with the CBI, in which we have made very serious allegations of corruption backed by some evidence, and the law laid down by a constitution bench of the Supreme Court in Lalita Kumari's case says that when such allegations are made, it is the duty of the CBI to register an FIR and investigate the matter. And that's what Justice Joseph has also held, while even he dismisses the review petition, but he holds that this is the duty of the CBI to investigate this matter. However, he points out that because of the amendment made in the Prevention of Corruption Act by this government recently, by which they require the permission of the government for the CBI to investigate a corruption case, therefore, the CBI will first have to seek the permission of the government before embarking upon any investigation. And on this aspect, the majority, that is the judgment of Justice Kaul and Chief Justice Gogoi, is totally silent. They right. don't deal with this aspect at all, which was the main contention that we had made.
However, sir, in the main judgment, while you know, I've gone through what you're saying, where one of the justices, Justice Joseph, says that you can go to the CBI, there's nothing that prevents anybody from going to the CBI to raise a complaint in this issue. The main order itself says, and I quote, it was the petitioner's decision to have invoked the jurisdiction of this court under Article 32, fully conscious of the limitation of the contours of the scrutiny, and not to take recourse to other remedies as may be available. The petitioners cannot be permitted to state that having so taken recourse to this remedy, they want an adjudication process which is really different from what is envisaged under the provisions invoked by them. In other words, and correct me, sir, if I'm wrong, they are indicating that you picked the wrong path. Is that interpretation correct?
No. So they are wrong here, because we didn't go to the court to ask the court to declare that this is a corrupt deal. We went to the court to say that you order an investigation, because we have made this complaint to the CBI and the CBI is not investigating the matter. They are not moving in the matter. And that's what Justice Joseph, he rightly deals with this issue, which the majority doesn't deal with. The majority seems to think that we are asking the court to declare the deal to be a corrupt deal, which is not what we were asking the court to do at all. They have completely misconstrued what we were asking for, whether willfully or not, but Justice Joseph has very, very correctly construed what we were asking for, and he has dealt with it very properly.
But Mr. Bhushan, in that same paragraph, Justice Joseph himself says, in a review petition, the petitioners cannot succeed. You selected a review petition, and the main body bears out why you could never succeed in a review petition because of the contours of this case. So hence my question to you, sir, the path you have selected, maybe you had no other option, but the path you selected was essentially limited.
So the path that we selected was to ask the CBI to conduct an investigation. Unfortunately, the majority judgment, that is the judgment authored by Justice Kaul on his behalf and on behalf of the Chief Justice, thinks or proceeds on the basis as if we were asking the court to declare this deal to be a corrupt deal, which is not what we had asked the court to do at all. Justice Joseph, on the other hand, deals with the matter in its correct perspective, though he dismisses the review on the ground that we have not asked for a direction to the government to grant permission to the CBI to investigate. Okay. And therefore, he says that it is perfectly open to the CBI to seek permission from the government and proceed to investigate this matter, despite the dismissal of this review.
Air Marshal SPP Sinha, good to have you on the program, sir. You negotiated the Rafale deal. I know you'll probably deny it now, but I'm sure there was a lot of pressure at the time only because there was a great deal of scrutiny. Today, the Supreme Court has ruled, they've dismissed the review petition. They dismissed this earlier on as well. And one of the points that they said, I think, is important from your standpoint. Apples cannot be compared with oranges. This deal cannot be compared with the old deal, which never happened. Do you believe that this was, in a sense, the summary of what you have been arguing for a very long time?
I have always said that the entire procurement process has been followed exactly as per the defense procurement procedure that were extant at that time, that was DPP 2013. And people quote of various sections, but what is important is, if I remember correctly, there is paragraph 71 and 72 that deals with intergovernmental agreements, and the entire procurement process was done in accordance with those agreements and with requisite approvals of Defense Acquisition Council, and after the contract negotiation of the Cabinet Committee on Security through the Ministry of Defense and Ministry of Finance. And I have always stated that there has been nothing wrong that has been done in this procurement, and I stand by it even today. And the Supreme Court and the CAG both had cleared this procurement. In fact, the CAG had clearly brought out that this procurement was cheaper than the previous procurement. And what we need to look at the price that we got at cheaper price, we got aircraft with much greater potency, with better weapons, better training package, extended warranty, more better logistic package, and better maintainability. So if you have got all this at a much cheaper cost than a price that was discovered through a multi-vendor procurement, I do not think that there should be any suspicion on the pricing. As far as the aircraft is concerned, it has been fully validated through technical evaluation and field evaluation, and it meets all the requirements. So there should be no doubt in anybody's mind about the capabilities of the aircraft and the process followed.
Okay. Vivek Reddy, some would say that this order sets a precedent that those of us who seek transparency, not in the overall pricing of a deal, which is always available, but in the breakup of the deal, if it cannot be revealed to us, it should at least be revealed to Parliament. That will not happen, that any government who pursues a big ticket defense deal or a small one as well, where there are several components, and the beauty lies in the detail, the controversy potentially lies in the detail, that breakup we will never know. So in the name of transparency, has this order in a sense failed us by setting a precedent?
I think there is a counterpoint to this, Vishnu. If everything lies in the details, all the details are the most important aspect of this deal, of a defense deal, then it is also important that the counter position should be understood, that what the enemy, our enemy, wants is those very details. Now, are we, in the name of transparency, to compromise our specifications, technical details, and our arsenal and weaponry,
no, cost,
reveal it to the
I'm
enemy
not talking
and allow
about
it
capability.
One to get prepared against
about
us.
Cost.
If these are serious issues of public interest.
No, but Vivek, I'll tell
these
you what.
These are serious issues of public interest.
If you look at the CAG reports in the past, they have said missile A or system X, and they have attached a cost. That's the way it used to be in the past. This time around, for the first time, the CAG has not revealed cost details, which a lot of people would say is problematic. Wouldn't you, as a taxpayer, and me as a taxpayer, don't you think we should have the right to knowing how much we are paying, even if we cannot say that this is the system and this is the capability? There's a big difference between the two. No one is saying reveal capability. One is only saying reveal cost.
Vishnu, the government is revealing all aspects of its functions, its governance, and the details of its expenditure in all fields. But only in defense, it holds it to its chest, and holds it because there are a number of army men who are serving this nation, number one.
And second is that it is too risky for the enemies to get that information.
Okay.
Even if you innocuously try to, in an indirect method like you suggested, you give this information, it is also dangerous because it will be very easy for the enemy. You are giving information to the enemy, which the enemy is never supposed to have it. In fact, the enemy has a huge network of spies to get that information, and we are making it public, only washing our dirty linen in public. The major issue, Vishnu, is that the Supreme Court has examined all these aspects of offsets, of decision-making process, and of every other aspect involving the deal, including the pricing. The Supreme Court went through those files, and it says that we don't find anything is there.
Okay.
The army man who spoke before us, the panelist, respected panelist, he says he was involved in finalizing the,
Air Marshal
contract. He says,
but I'm sure he has a great deal of respect for the army as well.
Now, two Air Marshal.
Go ahead.
Yes,
go ahead,
we have a great deal of respect for the army. Now, look at the high functionaries here. Yes. Vishnu, look at the high functionaries here. One, the judiciary of the nation, and the other is the Air Marshal. They come before this nation and say there is nothing here and this has to be respected.
Okay, Vivek,
how long
second.
Can we go on misleading the nation?
Okay, Vivek,
and keep saying, look here, there is 136 aircraft, you bought 36.
Alright, Vivek, I need to get a Congress now. I need to get a reaction from the Congress party as well so that I can balance out this panel. So I'm joined now by Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi. Dr. Singhvi, were you concerned, and be honest with us, sir, before you went into court today, that the court might actually have been far more harsh on Rahul Gandhi than it actually was? It let him off for the remarks which he made. You've tweeted about this. Were you worried, sir?
As you know, Vishnu, you had requested me for a one-to-one. I'm here for a
one-to-one. Yeah, so it's a one-to-one, sir. You were supposed to be on the top of the program.
There's no question. Right. Yeah.
But go ahead.
No problem. I know there is a bit of a mismatch. Now, there were four judgments since yesterday. And on three of those, I had appeared, not for the Rafale one you are discussing, but yes, in Rahul Gandhi's contempt. I think it was very clear in the arguments where we had made it clear that, yes, we have a right to say a lot of things in the political arena. We have a right to criticize the government, but we did not ever remotely intend to criticize or even talk of the judges at the Supreme Court. Yes, we also said in the heat of the moment, there are allusions which can be understood to be about the court, which was never the intention. The court has very clearly and carefully said that we are not concerned with what you do in the political arena, and you have a fundamental right, subject to the laws of defamation, to do that. But as far as the court is concerned, you must be more circumspect and careful. Our affidavit says precisely that, and that is why it's been accepted. The intention was, forget the actual doing, even the intention was not remotely. Because where is the question of suggesting that the court is in any way involved in the Chowkidar Chor Hai campaign? And I think that clarification, so I was very confident that the reason behind the whole thing would be seen. And though it has been delayed a lot, it's a very welcome judgment because it discharges Rahul Gandhi from contempt. And I think Rahul Gandhi did not at any point of time remotely even think of the court. But yes, the words used ought to have been more calibrated. And this happens in the heat of the political moment.
Okay. But Dr. Singhvi, I must ask you about the larger Rafale issue. Is it not an embarrassment to the Congress party that this entire case has been dismissed not once but twice in the Supreme Court? And you fought an election on the back of this?
I don't think that's quite right. But yes, I think I will concede that psychologically it does have some impression that there is nothing in the Rafale case, purely psychologically and optically, not really at all. And though people do react psychologically and optically, after a moment's rethink, they realize. Let me explain very quickly how. The Rafale judgment, now we talk about the non-contempt issue, of which I was not a part, we didn't argue anyway, is a matter where the crux of the judgment, the heart of it is, that you cannot come in this mega proceeding, in this macro level, to the Supreme Court, and ask that you be given a clean chit, that there will be FIR, that the investigation will lead to a charge sheet, that you will be arrested. These are macro issues. We find nothing so startling that we, the Supreme Court at the apex level, will do it. Point one. Point two, certainly I don't think the petitioners, Prashant Bhushan and others, wanted a culpability chit or a finding of corruption. But they did want that proceedings start, actions start through the police forces via the Supreme Court route. All that the court has said is, this is not the right route. It has not given a clean chit at all. It has also not given a culpability chit, which is equally wrong to have asked for. However, the third part is very important, though nuanced. The third line of judge makes it very clear, and that's the heart of the issue today, I think, which he concurs in the result, but says that tomorrow, if a well-conceived, well-drafted, properly buttressed complaint is filed to the appropriate authority, in this case, the appropriate authority could be a magistrate, could be a police agency, could be the CBI, that look, these are the documents which show culpability, please investigate. Well, he said, it is entirely possible and legal for that authority to investigate, for that authority to lodge an FIR, for that authority to charge.
But Dr. Singhvi,
now,
but Dr. Singhvi,
I do understand
the point that you mentioned
in a real world, one second, Vishnu. In the real world, our problem is that with the overpowering government we have, we cannot expect that independence from a prosecuting agency, be it the CBI or the police.
Okay, but the point that you're saying
against the powers that be.
No, but sir, but with all due respect, Dr. Singhvi, the point that you're saying is that the Supreme Court hasn't said anything to say that this case was a rubbish case, as it were. In fact, a lot of people would say that by dismissing the petitions and a lot of the remarks, they have fairly contemptuously let go of this case. I accept the point you're making about Justice Joseph read out 6 or 7 very pointed points. I mean, for example, on the issue of differences, the Supreme Court said differences can exist. They have said the review petitions, quote, are without any merit and are accordingly dismissed. Point number two. On number three, apples cannot be compared with oranges. That is the core of the Congress argument. And I could go on and on. Right? So therefore, how can you say that they've not rejected these arguments altogether?
See, first of all, I made the point about concurrence. If your interpretation is correct, then the concurrence cannot be a concurrence at all. It should be dissent. So that's obviously a concurrence, which means that we are not deciding that they are culpable. We are not remotely suggesting that there is culpability.
No, they were not meant to get into culpability, sir,
because
they've said the contours are limited. I don't think anything
says that we are getting into a clean chit. No, equally, they are not saying that we are giving a clean chit. I'll tell you why. Let's forget this Justice Joseph's concurrence. Let's forget the judgment today of the majority also.
Okay.
Suppose hypothetically tomorrow, you were to go to an independent police force. That doesn't exist, I know, in the sense in which I mean it. But suppose there was an independent agency, completely. Let's say the Lokpal was completely.
Right. Dr. Singhvi, I need to move on to my next.
And you gave this material saying, Vishnu is guilty of all this.
Yes.
Do you think that the Supreme Court judgment prevents that inquiry? It doesn't.
Okay.
So Supreme Court only says, this is not the right way to bring to us. We can't do it.
Okay, fair enough. Mamta Kale, last comment to you on this particular issue. The issue of dissent within the administration was something that came up as well. And the Supreme Court seemed to suggest, look, there may have been many opinions, but that doesn't mean that that is an indicator of corruption. A lot of the arguments by those who opposed the deal were that, look, people have come and said that they disagree and that their opinions have been, there's been a roughshod process over their views and the deal has been thrust down their throats. But the Supreme Court seems to say, and I quote, the different views expressed, considered and dealt with, right, that's part of the process. So isn't that a major point as well?
Yes, it is. And I want to thank Air Marshal Sinha. He's made everything very clear that the deal was absolutely correct and it was clean and clear deal in principle and procedure. And that's exactly what today the court has said. So they have dismissed everything, all the allegation leveled by the petitioners as well as by the Congress party. Today, the opposition has got a befitting reply by the court when they said that Rahul Gandhi needs to be very careful. Just now, Mr. Singhvi was saying that, you know, he has said what he said and called names to our Prime Minister in heat of the moment.
Yeah, but he's apologized.
No,
and the Supreme Court has
accepted
the
but
apology.
Not,
so that's
not,
where the matter
he's
ends.
He's not lied once, Vishnu, by the way. Let me tell you.
No,
he did not. He lied on the floor of the House
this
also
was, this was
when
a,
he said,
but
Vishnu,
Mamta,
Vishnu,
there's
let
a
me
difference
complete.
Between attacking the Prime Minister and attacking the Supreme Court.
He did. That is
he's
what I'm saying.
Up
so he's been
for attacking the Supreme Court.
So
he apologized.
But how he
but in the heat
used,
of the moment, political
used,
language of political
used,
leaders goes on.
No, he used the court to call names to the Prime Minister
but
just to get the political
benefit. He was in trouble for the remarks against the court, not against the Prime Minister.
So he used...
You can disagree with his comments against the Prime Minister.
But he tried to use the court, lied on behalf by using the court to call names to the Prime Minister, and he didn't do this. By the way, he said... He lied on the floor of the house also when he said that I have spoken to the French president regarding the Rafale case.
And by evening,
it was dismissed by the French government by saying that nothing has upset that sort of happened.
So one way or the other, it's an important judgment which has taken place over here. Will there be more transparency in defense deals going forward? That's perhaps a question mark. But one way or the other, the process which Air Marshal Sinha was a part of, that process appears to be okay, and the process of acquisition continues. The Air Force, nobody disputes this fact, needs more aircraft. Thank you all very much for being with us.